Welcome to another episode of the Valorant Tips and Tricks Sent by You series, a series where I show Valorant tips and tricks that you guys send to me. Like always, I'll be giving away one battle pass to one random submission, so if you want to submit something, feel free to join my Discord server or tag me on Twitter. It's already episode 24, my friends, let's start the video. Imagine, you think it's clear, you walk with your knife in your hand and you want to take the orb. But then suddenly an enemy appears, so you stop taking the orb but you still have your knife in your hand. There's an easy fix for this. Go to controls, then click on equipment and check this little box over here. Now when you start taking the orb with your knife in your hand, and you stop, you immediately have your gun in your hand. This sage wall I don't see a lot of people using, but it might be useful in some situations. On split, when you have control over A side, CT is smoked for example, you can place your wall on this box and jump on your own wall. And now you're suddenly on rafters. You can hold CT or you can even push to heaven if you are feeling confident. And let's do another sage wall. This one is very funny. You know, on A side on bind, a lot of people are planting the spike next to the first wheel of the truck. So what you can do is stand on the other side of the truck, and when you hear the enemy is planting the spike, use your wall. You will boost the enemy up together with yourself, and you can kill him while he has still the spike in his hand. I know, it sounds too good to be true, but look at this clip from Valerion. Enemy remaining. Very smart play, my friend. On split with chamber, you can place one side of your teleporter on B heaven and the other one over here on A ramps. Now you can peek ramps, and if there's nobody there, you can instantly teleport back to B. You're basically holding two sides at the same time. It's very good. I have to admit something though, this trick nobody sent to me. I got it straight from the guide section on the sponsor of this video, Valorant Tracker. On the app, you can click on guides, click on your favorite agents, and you can find tons of tips and tricks. You can even submit your own, like some of you did for this video. But this is just one part of the app. Valorant Tracker has tons of other features, all with the purpose of helping you improve in game. You can for example see your own stats, win rate, accuracy, and even how many aces you got. You can also put these stats on a timeline so you can see what periods you played good or bad, and if you are improving of course. Or you can look at your specific weapon stats, map stats, or agent stats. Ah, it took me 81 wins to get from gold to diamond with the Neon to Diamond series. Another awesome feature from Valorant Tracker is the live match info. When you hop into a game, you can see your total damage, your average damage, and even how many kills you got in each round. On top of that, before you hop into a game, you can see all the ranks of your teammates and your enemies. In conclusion, Valorant Tracker offers you tons of tools to help you win games. If you got excited by this, feel free to download Valorant Tracker with the link in the description. It's completely free, so try it out today. And now, let's continue the video. Let's continue with the nice cypher trick on Fracture. When you're about to push A, most of the time the left side is walled off by a Viper or a Sage for example. When this happens, try to plant a spike over here. After that, go upstairs to the platform, stand in this corner, aim at the bottom of the ledge and throw your cage. Now you can simply camp over here, and when the enemy is defusing, activate your cage. It will be a one way and you can easily kill the enemy. You could also walk all the way around and peek from here. Very nice. And now a trick from when you are playing against the Reyna. Apparently when Reyna uses her flash and she walks in front of it, you can spot her shadow if you look really closely. This is actually really overpowered. Another reason why you only should use your flash high in the sky or low in the ground when you play Reyna. Otherwise this might happen. One note though, it only works if Reyna is walking in front of her flash and not behind her flash. Did you know that you can cancel the charge of your Sova bow by pressing the ability button? I didn't know this. Is this an update or was it always in the game? At least we know it now and we will never forget it. Now two very cool one-way walls on Haven. The first one is very simple. When the barriers are going down, just walk a little bit down, jump and place your wall like this. Now there's a small gap you can see through. When the enemies are pushing, they will most likely look up. But if they look down, it's very hard for them to shoot through the small gap. So easy kills for you, my friends. It works especially good with an operator. And the second one is over here. Simply jump and place your wall on these boxes. When you stand next to Garage, you can look all the way to CT. The enemies will have a hard time looking back. Easy kills for Drissos. Now let's go back to one of the oldest tricks in the books, the Killjoy Ultimate Swarm Grenade combo. However, this time on Fracture. Normally, people would place the Killjoy Ultimate in this corner. But instead, you could also place your ultimate over here, and suddenly a small gap will appear. It's the only safe spot on site, so enemies might chill in this corner. So what you can do is go to these boxes, aim at the spot where there are no plants, and then do a jumping throw. Your Swarm Grenade will land into the corner, and easy kills for you. And let's do another trick on Fracture. This one is very simple. It's just a Viper wall, but I don't see a lot of people using it. Stand over here and aim towards the nest. Now you can either choose to aim a little bit to the left and block off nest, or aim a little bit to the right and don't block off nest. I prefer the second option. And now you can basically just walk onto the side like it's nothing. Very OP, my friends. Now a quick cypher trick on ascent. If you're bored of always doing the same setup, try this one. Place your trap on this box and then the cage next to the wall in heaven. There's a high chance that the enemies don't expect your trap over there, and when they walk through it, easy kills for you. On top of that, your cage is a very nice tool for the retake. Activate it, you can jump to hell and clear the site from hell. Very good job, Taka Sugio.
Yes.
This next one is not a trick, but it's a very funny glitch a lot of people were sending to me. On Icebox, stand on these barrels, aim to the right of the tube and place your clone down. And when you activate it, Yoru, are you okay, my friend? I think he's okay, he's just chilling, sliding down, you know. This got me wondering. Yes, this game is so funny, my friends. I love this game. This is how you play Valorant. Anyway, we're getting off topic. Let's go to B-side for a nice trick. This is how to kill enemies planting on the default plant on Icebox. When you are standing in nest, it's very dangerous to peek the enemy. So what you can do is smoke yourself in nest, then ping the spike and easy kills for you, my friend. If you don't have a smoke, no worries. You could also stand a little bit more to the left and shoot through the wall of the nest. This might not always work because you might shoot on the container. But if it works, easy kills for you. I like lineups, but there's one type of lineup that I especially like. The lineups that you won't forget. And this is one of those. Just go to this corner, aim at the satellite and shoot your molly. The molly will land on these boxes. Nice one if you play against the jet, for example. With Neon on split, you could use your wall over this building. It will nicely block off all the enemies that are standing on site, T-spawn and heaven. However, you have to be careful because there will be a small gap. But because peeking into one angle instead of five different angles, I think this wall is pretty okay. On top of that, who is standing there, right? And let's stay on split for a very situational cypher cage, but it could be useful. If you manage to go from mid to B, try placing your cage on rafters. After that, plant the spike under your cage and chill on the back of B. When you hear the peep peep, activate it and peek, my friends. I really like these type of one ways because there's very little counterplay. So let's do another one, this time on Fracture. This one you could use more often than the last one. Simply throw your cage in between the pipe and the generator. And that's it, just chill in nest and peek when you hear the peep peep. Now a nice Viper ultimate you can use for the post plant. On B side on ascent, try to plant the spike somewhere so you can wallbang through the lever room. After that, stand against this crate, aim to the corner and cast your ultimate. With this ultimate, you can sneaky peeky walk to the lever room, then just ping the spike and shoot when the enemy defuses. It's a very cool trick. A teammate of Broxol got some nice kills with it. With Yoru, you could place the clone down next to the teleport door and the door will open. This used to be a trick, but then it got fixed, but now you can do it again, so use it, my friends. Don't you guys also love April Fools? Thank you so much for this trick, moderate nickname. At least you tricked me. You get it? It's a joke. I'm really inside my room for too long, my friends. Anyway, here's a nice wallbang spot you can use with any agent on Fracture. At the start of the round, jump on these boxes and aim at the dark part of the iron platings. You might be able to do some damage or even kill the enemy standing in heaven. I would be very tilted. Now a unique kill setup on Fracture. Place your alarm bot next to the box and your nano swarms like this. Then go to the platform, place your turret down and boost yourself up. I would recommend to practice this boost in a custom game. But once you get on the box, go all the way to the right and crouch. When your alarm bot goes off, activate your nano swarms. The enemies will have to walk into your crosshair or walk back into your nano swarms. Easy kills. The only problem is that you are standing in the open if the enemies are pushing satellites or going through the door. So only use this trick if you have teammates that are holding that. And since we're discussing so many complicated tricks, we often forget the simple ones. This lineup on Icebox is so good. A trick doesn't have to be complicated to be good, my friends. One tip though, Otakinu, don't you ever stand in middle on top of the ramps with your knife in your hand like that. Even though you know it's clear, it's never a good thing to do, my friend. But well played. If you're feeling aggressive with Sage, you can jump on these boxes by placing your wall underneath you. I would not recommend to do this at the start of the round, but it's a nice one if your teammate is calling that all the enemies are in garage and you want to kill the rotators. Very risky though, so be careful. And this is it. Big thanks to the people for helping with this video and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.